Hello everyone, I'm the Saxy Gamer, and today we're here for yet another Civilization VI Wonder Spotlight, where today we'll be taking a look at one of the two new wonders that was added in the latest iteration of the New Frontier Pass, and that is Torre de Belém. So this wonder is obviously linked to Portugal, who was the new civ that was added in the last iteration of the New Frontier Pass. So this is a wonder that is unlocked with the Mercantilism Civic, making it a Renaissance-era wonder. In order to get the inspiration for Mercantilism, all that you have to do is have a great merchant recruited, which, if you're playing a economic game, in which you probably would be if you want to build Torre de Belém, then you'll probably have a great merchant recruited by this point in the game, so pretty easy to get the inspiration there. As far as the building requirements for Torre de Belém are concerned, they are pretty straightforward. It's just that it has to be on a coast tile that is adjacent to a harbor, so if you're playing any super heavy trade-focused civ, chances are you probably have at least one harbor in your land, so you probably will have at least one spot to be able to build this wonder. One thing, though, is that sometimes coastal cities don't have that great of production, so it is something to keep in mind is that you're going to have a coastal city that has enough production, because this has a production cost of 920, so if it's a newly founded coastal city, you're going to have about, you know, a million turns to produce this wonder, but in any reasonably built-up coastal city, you should be able to place down Torre de Belém pretty easily. Let's now go ahead and talk about Torre de Belém's bonuses, and there are quite a few of them, so it might take a little bit here. So for one, it will make it so that your international trade routes from the city that the wonder is built in receive +2 gold for each luxury resource at the destination city. In addition to this, oh, my sous vide is beeping, which means my steak is now going to be cooking. But in addition to this, whenever you construct the wonder, all the cities that are not on your home continent receive the lowest cost building that they can construct, and you also do get a flat bonus of +5 gold per turn and 1 great admiral point per turn. So let's start going through and talking about each of these bonuses and what I think about them. So first up, the international trade routes getting +2 gold for each luxury resource at the destination. I think that this part is okay. I think this is probably the better of the two parts whenever it comes to Torre de Belém, but this one as well is, it's quite unpredictable just because there's really no guaranteeing how many luxuries you can have at a destination city that you're trying to trade to. So a lot of the time it'll be maxed out at, you know, like 4 or so. A lot of the time you won't even get quite 4 luxury resources at a destination city, but you know, if you pick and choose, then maybe. But still, sometimes this can offset the cost going to a normally worse city than what you would be otherwise trading to for other bonuses, you know, like having different districts and things of that sort, or different distances away. So this extra gold can offset that difference in gold per turn between cities. But if it's in a already good city, then the other issue here is that you can only have one trade route that has the same source and destination city. So like you couldn't have 2 trade routes both going from Lisbon to New York. You can only have one. So you're really only going to be able to capitalize on a city that has a lot of luxury resources with one trade route, because you can't just spam them all there, because this bonus will only apply to the city that Torre de Belém is built in. You can sometimes get lucky and then you'll have a lot of cities that have a lot of luxury resources, which can get you some extra gold, but still, it's not always guaranteed. It's very variable, and the way to really make good use of this is to make sure that you have a lot of trade routes to be able to go to a lot of cities. So this really is very much suited towards economic civs such as Portugal or the Mali or someone like that, maybe even Phoenicia as well. So the second bonus, that when constructed, cities not on your home continent receive the lowest cost building that they can construct. This one is not particularly good, I don't think. The reason it's not good is just because it's so hard to control what you actually get out of this. So in theory, this can be good. Because, you know, if the lowest cost building that you can produce is like a university or something like that, then obviously that's going to be pretty decent. But if the lowest cost city or the lowest cost building in most of your cities is a monument, then this is obviously not going to be, you know, really all that great. The other thing here is that it's only on cities that are not on your home continent. So for those of you who don't know, your home continent is just whatever capital or whatever continent your capital is settled on. So in certain games, you can only have like 1 or 2 cities that are settled on different continents, which is going to make this really bad. So in the game that I played as Portugal on stream recently, I had a lot of cities settled on a lot of different islands, but the problem was they were all on the same continent. So I literally got no bonus out of this, which makes this a very random, combined with the fact that the bonus itself is random in terms of what building you get, and also the fact that your ability to settle to other continents is somewhat random because it depends on your spawn, means that this is a very random ability and it's really hard to control. And then lastly, the passive bonuses, the 5 gold per turn and great admiral point per turn, are, I mean, they're fine. I would never pay 920 production for just 5 gold per turn, but this is an okay bonus. It at least gives you something rather than nothing, even if you are getting really unlucky with this wonder's other bonuses. And now it is that time to give Torii de Bellemi its wonder rating. So all that you really need to know here is that these ratings go on a 1 to 5 scale where 1 is the worst and 5 is the best. So for its overall rating, I think that Torii de Bellemi deserves a 2. It's not really struck me as a particularly good wonder, mainly just because of how variable it is, and also the cases in which you'd want to build it, which we'll talk about just, I guess we'll talk about them right now. So this one really can give you a slight increase in gold per turn from trade routes in a city, obviously. That's the main bonus I would consider from it. I honestly don't even consider the extra buildings. Never try to build this wonder specifically for the extra buildings that you'll get, because it's so hard to control what you actually get out of it, and the fact that you have to be settled, it only applies to the cities on other continents that are not your home continent, make it even more difficult to control. So really the only use case I can see for building this wonder is to try to get more gold per turn from having trade routes. But the thing is, the way to really get any significant bonus out of this is to have a lot of trade route slots on someone like, you know, the Mali or Portugal or Phoenicia or someone like that. But the issue here, whenever you think about that, is that civs like that that are already very economically based don't really care if you get, you know, six extra gold per turn from a trade route from having three luxuries in a city that you're going to, because in the game that I built this, I already had 2,000 gold per turn by the time that I was making this. All right, maybe 1,000. So getting an additional, even if the combined effect from all the trade routes is like 30 gold per turn, getting 30 extra gold per turn when you're already making 1,000 really doesn't matter that much, you know? So it's kind of the dilemma of Torii de Bellemi, of it's not very good on civs that aren't trade focused, but on civs that are trade focused, it's not particularly useful because you already have enough gold per turn anyways. So that's kind of why I think it's conflicting and deserving of the 2. The other reason I think it's deserving of the 2 is just because of the consistency issues, which we'll obviously talk about again whenever we talk about its consistency rating. But difficulty rating is up first, and I think it deserves a 1. It's a very easy wonder to build. Very simple building requirements, and like most new wonders, the AI don't really prioritize it very much, so maybe in future patches this will change whenever they actually get programmed to prioritize it a little bit, but haven't really had any issues trying to build this one. They don't seem to go for it super hard, so I would say that it is a 1 in difficulty, very easy to build in general. For its consistency rating, though, I think that it deserves a 2. It's really not particularly consistent, so parts of it are somewhat consistent. Obviously, you get the passive bonuses, so you're at least going to get something out of this wonder every time, but the other issue with it is that the amount of gold per turn that you get from it is going to be extremely variable based on both the luxuries in other people's cities and the number of trade routes you have. You're always going to get some sort of bonus from this, unless you're sending literally no trade routes from the city that you've built it in, but assuming you're not totally dumb and don't do that, then you're going to be getting at least some bonus from this wonder, so that's why I think it deserves a 2 rather than a 1, but that combined with the fact that the buildings are random and your spawn is also going to be depending on, how good this is will also depend on how good your spawn is in terms of being able to settle on other continents, makes this a fairly inconsistent wonder and deserving of the 2 inconsistency. So thank you everyone for watching. I have been the Saxy Gamer. If you enjoy the video, feel free to like. If not, feel free to dislike. If you're looking for some more Civilization 6 content, feel free to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.